What's going on, barbecue family? Welcome to another episode, and I want to go ahead and extend a huge thank you to everyone that subscribed to my YouTube channel, to everyone that started following me on Instagram, and to everyone that started following me on Reddit. You guys are amazing. I had a couple questions about fire management and what works best for me. I'm going to go ahead and address that right now while I'm here right next to the firebox. It's pretty hot. But basically, what I have seen in the barbecue industry a lot is the Lincoln log method. It works, but you know, there's room for improvement. The more airflow and the less contact with the coal bed, the better. I noticed when I use this method, I don't have a name for it or anything like that. But I notice when I use this method, I'm actually able to keep a very consistent temperature at 250 for about 30 to 35 minutes. So this is what I like to do. I like to have one log go across here, and I like to have the other logs come across like that. It gives me less point of contact with the coal bed, and I have very efficient airflow going through. One thing too, if I go ahead and say for some reason I'm having trouble with temperatures, it's just one of those days, maybe it's a little bit colder, I'll go ahead and grab another piece of wood and I'll show you guys real quick. And I'll place it like this. Again, it's not touching the coal bed. The coal bed still has efficient airflow. That log's gonna catch very, very quickly. All right, here we go. So right now I'm sitting right at 255. That's totally okay. That works for me. I'd rather be a little bit hotter than a little bit cooler than my targeted temperature. I always like to play that game, 5 degrees below, 5 degrees above. If I notice that the temperature starts to get to 10, 15, 20 degrees hotter, I'll go ahead and open up the door a little bit and try to flood some colder air into the cook chamber. If it gets even hotter than that, like 50 degrees above the targeted temperature, maybe I'll go ahead and open up the door. But I got a lot of trimming to do. There's a train, of course, right when I start to film. But basically tonight what I have to do, I got some poppers I need to work on, I got some beef cheeks, I got some pork belly, and I got some spare ribs. And I'm going to go ahead and get started on that so that I can have all my focus later on the briskets when I start to wrap.
Thank you.
I hope that my fire management method can help you guys out at home. If you can go ahead and leave a comment down below in this video, let me know if that helps you guys out at all. I'll probably do a more in-depth video about fire management pretty soon. But man, I think I'm gonna go to bed. But hey, please subscribe, like this video, and if you're on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. It's pitman underscore Drew. If you're on Reddit, follow me there. And I'll do little pop-ups of everything. But I'm gonna go get some sleep. I'm exhausted. You guys have a good one, and I'll catch y'all later.